year, defending when you go to the line, a group of 20 were away earlier on in the race, and you were right at the head of that break there. I did expect you two guys to be caught, but you were saying coming in the road, it was bit and bit. You looked behind and the Butch were right on top of you.
Yeah, we just didn't realise they were coming back that fast. We noodled around a bit and they just got back onto us, and I let it out from before the corner, just that was it, and Joe Martin Locken got up to us and Joe came by and that was it.
Okay, listen, put your hands together. Congratulations, of course, Martin is the Olympic road manager, the cycling manager for the Irish team this year. You were there to the fore, Rory Wiley and yourself always in the moves, of course, a former national champion. I do expect that when you got across the two guys, you said, I have a real chance here of taking the title.
Yeah, well, I couldn't believe that they were actually there. They were just admiring each other or something with a day to go. And I looked up there and just thanks for waiting, lads. I took a big chance going around the last bend, which I normally wouldn't do, but it was the championships on the line. Maybe went a little bit too early, but look, Joe Fenlon, Joe would beat me 7 times out of 10 anyway in a sprint, whether we started with 100 metres or 500 metres, you know. So it's great, he's a deserving champion.
Who's in second place? Put your hands together, Mark Lockie. Magnificent ride by both of you, indeed Martin as well. The podium, yeah. Richly deserving for all three of you.
Yeah.
I didn't see you staying away to the finish, I have to say, and I know around the back of the course, Greg Swinnard attacked, and you really had to really dig in to get back up to him.
Yeah, had to dig very deep. Deeper than I did in a long time. Yeah, it was tough, like, at the start, like we were saying, of course, maybe not tough enough, but as it went on, it has sort of started to wear into us, especially up the road so long. Greg was absolutely brilliant, like riding through, it was just very, very strong.
Yeah, I see two experienced guys working, doing 50.
We sort of knew, like, look, we just had to do it. And,
but I'm sure it was a great disappointment, Greg mentioned earlier on, 1 kilometre to go, you turned around, looked around and saw the bunch close.
Yeah,
so the gap came from 50 seconds right back.
We had about 700 to go, you know, the corner was about 500 and it was about 700 to go. I was sort of, Greg came up by me like that, and I just looked for a look, and next minute I just seen the full road across, and I went, oh no. I shouted at Greg, I said, look behind you. So with that, we luckily dropped the hammer, and we just went into the corner, and then Martin came up, and I said, oh no, again.
But explain to you, you've got 300 metres to go, Martin and Lachlan arrived right at the back of you two guys, you've been out there for 2/3 of the race, anyways. What were you thinking at that stage?
I was thinking, how was he going to sprint? Because we had about a K to go, I had to stand up on the back because I was getting cramps in my legs. So, to be honest, for me it was looking bad with a K to go. But I put it in a slightly lower gear, spun it a bit for luck, because when Martin came by us, I was like, I had to put it in the 12, I think it was in the 12, because I wouldn't have been able to spin one hard enough. And they left me a gap in between, so I just came through the centre.
As you did, just to win by a few millimetres. Listen, give them a massive round of applause.